Okay, televiewers, we continue with the discussions. As I earlier told you, we are looking at the two different releases, one coming from a coalition of some prominent opposition political leaders who decided to meet in Yaoundé recently, and the raison d'etre of their meeting was to chart a way forward on how the electoral code in Cameroon could be revised or amended to move the country forward. And shortly after that, Professor Jacques Famine Ndongo, who is the communications secretary at the Central Committee of the ruling CPDM party, who is equally the Minister of State, Minister of Higher Education, rubbished the said meeting with another release that he published later yesterday, Audrey. Mbane Elvis, we don't know if you're still on the line.
Yes, Mr. Lasha, I'm on the line.
Okay, when you read through the communique of the Minister of State, Minister of Higher Education, rubbishing or making a mockery of the meeting of some of the prominent opposition figures in Cameroon, what do you make of his release?
Well, Mr. Lasha, for some time now, our lines have always been the best. Since you are talking about Professor Famine Ndongo and his respect to the coalition that was as opposition leaders.
Yes.
He did not make a mockery of them, but then he rather make a mockery of himself. Because, you know, I always say leaders in this country are a political joke. And when you look at all what Famine Ndongo said, you rather tell that there are two incongruities in what he said, because he Cameroon's impression that political our country are liberal, but at the same time, not seeing why people sit and saw them on down, able to get national debates to take place. Secondly, he says the president that could be have is a constitutional one that was proposed, depended upon and promulgated by the head of state. But at the end of the day, he doesn't understand that we have come to a time where electoral code needs to be amended. And some things are in place of Cameroonians. So, like you said, I think he made a mockery of himself. All what he said, what he brought out, may not make them.
Laws are made in parliament. And interestingly, one of the opposition leader is not having any representative in parliament. So why do you consider that as a mockery of himself, what he said as a mockery of himself? Is he not right to a certain extent?
There is a call for political parties to propose what they think makes better electoral for Cameroonian. And the one which has done is they have a petition and they are fighting Cameroonians, the finest strength they can have, be it the country or even the diaspora, to bring forth the electoral code. They did not say they were going to propose their ideas and the streets. And like I said, he made himself because he should have understood and he should have taken note of the fact that with this that met, these three members of parliament will be who could eventually take the proposal to the National Assembly. So the conclusions of the fact that the laws are not in the streets. I don't know how he got to that. I don't know how to interpret the procedure. And that's why I keep repeating that so that became a more of the
that came together. The party to which you are the communication secretary was not part of that meeting, and we know you guys, we know your stand, what you stand for. So this is very surprising to many Cameroonians that political party was not part of that meeting.
Thank you very much let me just clear Cameroonians, we were not a it does not mean that we shall not join in the Sahel or the Sahel. The truth is that the PDP was consulted, but it was simply a much clear that the middle to be part of it. That we strongly support the coalition, share the same as we do, and that stands for any Cameroonian support. So it should not take on our way to surprise the PAP come on board head. So I want to think that the reason the PAP was not, it's just a matter of the ship. But then, I want to say the out Ms. Famine Ndongo, I want to see that his serious reaction tells you that there is karma of fear already on the part of the place, and that you have to come out of it over the as he said, and that is the opportunity to call on this simple and all those that it is a time for to put the of that beyond the idea of an electoral code, because there are too many in this code as to which we need to come a solid position. That to all those who are on this coalition, they must understand that we have to be kept aside.
Okay, Evis, sorry the lines are breaking. We'll be coming back to you. Rizaza, let's come back to Kamten Etape in the studio to give his own reading of Famindongo's release. What do you think of the release rubbishing the meeting that was held yesterday or 2 days back by the coalition of opposition political party leaders?
Monsieur Lacha, il faut dire que la politique, c'est la politique. La politique, lorsqu'on utilise tous les moyens et que ces moyens sont efficaces et bons, et puis ça peut nous faire atteindre des objectifs, tant mieux.
Donc chacun bagage de son côté. Révise le code électoral dans la rue. Je cite Famine Dongo.
Bien, on ne saurait, c'est-à-dire trouver la solution à ce problème dans une condition précaire. Voyez-vous, c'est déjà une très bonne idée que les oppositions s'entendent, parce que il y a fort longtemps, il en fallait pour que des idées parviennent de part et d'autre, à gauche, à droite. Vous savez, lorsque on dit souvent, lorsque une main se permet d'attacher un mais, elle ne pourra pas. Lorsque les deux sont réunis ensemble, eh bien, il y a une force, la synergie. Donc, si le communicant du RDPC a empêché ou bien dit qu'il n'y a rien à modifier sur le code électoral, je pense que c'est une façon d'empêcher l'opposition, c'est-à-dire l'adversaire.
Mais c'est le Parlement qui fait la loi, ce n'est pas l'opposition dans la rue ou dans certaines gatherings in quarters.
Justement.
Laws are made in Parliament.
Justement, pour être honnête, c'est dans l'Assemblée nationale qu'on fait la loi. L'Assemblée nationale, c'est l'usine dans laquelle on produit les lois. Après avoir produit les lois, ces lois sont respectées et nul n'est censé les ignorer.
Comment est-ce qu'ils vont réussir? Parce que, let me speak in English, maybe you help me. Because in Cameroon, we've never had a private member bill that is sent by opposition to parliament and parliament validates and is promulgated by the president of the republic as law. We've never had that. How do you think these people call themselves coalition of opposition parties putting a technical secretariat will be able to achieve this revision of the electoral code?
Justement, l'on observe que déjà au niveau de l'Assemblée nationale, c'est difficile déjà à faire passer, c'est-à-dire nos besoins, c'est-à-dire lorsqu'on envoie une loi, cette loi, elle est tout simplement refoulée. Qu'est-ce qui a
bloqué, rejeté?
Qu'est-ce qui apporte cela? Est-ce que c'est parce que l'Assemblée nationale est dominée par le régime en place, le parti du régime en place? L'on a envie tout de même de se poser la question, si c'est ça, est-ce que l'Assemblée nationale ne mériterait pas d'être neutre, d'avoir un statut neutre en ce qui concerne les affaires politiques? Parce que l'Assemblée nationale, voyez-vous, Monsieur Lacha, est un lieu de rencontre de plusieurs partis politiques. Il y a le RDPC,
they have the swelling majority, which means that anything their MPs will
voilà,
still vote.
Vous le dites très bien. Le RDPC est un parti majoritaire, et ce qui fait que lorsqu'une loi arrive à l'Assemblée nationale, c'est difficile qu'elle soit adoptée dans l'intérêt, peut-être, je le dirais,
de
général.
La population.
Voilà, dans l'intérêt général de toutes les partis politiques, parce que Voyez-vous, dans la politique, la bataille qu'on mène, c'est de conserver, n'est-ce pas, le pouvoir. Eh bien, si les oppositions, les partis d'opposition veulent, n'est-ce pas, que le code électoral qui est là ne soit plus taillé à la sur-mesure du régime en place, c'est-à-dire s'enfoncer le bâton dans les roues. Maintenant, je crois que c'est un problème.
Mais quand on voit ça, c'est quelque chose de sérieux, hein, c'est quelque chose de sérieux quand on
Et
voit ça.
Quentin, pour ces leaders de l'opposition camerounaise qui n'ont justement pas de représentants à l'Assemblée nationale, que dire
Par exemple, Maurice
Maurice
Kamto, on
Kamto,
peut
par
en citer
exemple?
le cas de Maurice Kamto.
Bien, il sait pourquoi il n'a pas un représentant à l'Assemblée nationale. C'est peut-être justement qu'il mène une bataille. Donc, il a besoin des solutions probantes et efficaces pour, n'est-ce pas, viabiliser le secteur politique. Parce que l'on a comme impression que dans ce domaine, il y a une partie qui est dominante et qui, n'est-ce pas, veut rester éternelle sur.
Qui veut rester éternel
Voilà.
au pouvoir?
Qui
Thank you,
veut rester éternel au pouvoir. Pourtant, le
Tapé
dit-on, la démocratie, c'est aussi l'alternance politique. Mais c'est ce qui est pratiquement, ou bien quasiment invisible dans notre cher et beau
Thank you
pays.
very much,
Merci, Quentin.
Tapé. We've come to the end of the program. Have a great weekend.
Ah, je vous remercie de m'avoir invité. Vous savez, celui qui détient l'information détient le pouvoir.
Ah, exactement.
Et qui détient le pouvoir doit entretenir le monde. Donc, c'est avec un plaisir que j'étais avec vous et je serai là autant opportun
Thank
si
you.
vous en avez besoin de
Thank
moi.
you.
En tout cas, mesdames, messieurs, c'est la fin de cette édition et pardon encore pour ces problèmes techniques que nous avons dû rencontrer. On espère en tout cas, prenons rendez-vous pour lundi.
Thank you, televiewers, for watching. The program was produced by Christian Tebon, and for presentation, we've been Audrey Zaxa and myself, Lasha Kingsley. Have a great weekend and a great vendredi, on dit, vendredi saying, or a good Friday. Bye bye. See you on Monday.